The COVID-19 pandemic marked a shift in how companies and business leaders think about employees' physical and mental health. And most have met the call. More than three quarters of employees say their company is taking appropriate health and safety measures to protect their staff. That's according to the ADP Research Institute. Joining us now to discuss, Jim Lord, SVP and GM of ADP Insurance Services. Jim, welcome to the show. So how did the pandemic accelerate the evolution of health and safety, not only for employees, but for businesses as a whole as well?
Yeah, first of all, thank you so much for having me. You know, it's such an important topic. I think the pandemic really magnified the importance of what health and safety means as a business priority for leaders today. You know, I think about the very basic concept of the service profit chain model, where you focus on employees who are then going to focus on doing great things for your customers, who will then do great things for your business, right? And I think the pandemic really forced employers to double click into that whole concept of what does it mean to take great care of your employees today? And the research that we did that you just mentioned showed us that 53% of people, 53% of employees believe that their work is actually suffering as a result of the pandemic. So 53% of employees think their work is suffering due to poor mental health. And so we're seeing a shift where top employers today are really starting to double down and focus on delivering well-being options to their employees.
So given this changing environment, the focus on mental health, as you well know, Jim, has been magnified, especially over the last 2 years. How have employers responded to this emerging priority? Because it was such a shift in the mindset.
It was a huge shift, right? I mean, we all had to learn almost overnight how to work from home. Potentially, we had children who were being schooled from home. Hopefully, you know, we didn't have to become a caregiver, but for certainly some did, you know, all from home, which brought new stresses to the employees who were also trying to hold down a full-time job and remain productive, right? So I think through that environment, employers have learned how to deliver a more tailored and customized benefits approach and offering to their employees versus kind of a broad brush, one size fits all that they might have been offering in the past. You know, I think employers are rethinking wellness and well-being in ways where, of course, they care about the financial and the physical well-being, but they're also starting to care about the emotional and even the social well-being of their employees. The ADP Research Institute study that you mentioned, you know, also mentions that more than 50% of employees would be willing to take a pay cut today if it meant it would improve their work-life balance. And so our research shows that most employers plan to differentiate their benefit offerings to include wellness components over the next 2 years.
How can workers themselves better access health and safety resources that are available to them, Jim?
This one's so important, right? Because I think for a long time, benefits administration, particularly for small business owners, was always really viewed as being complex and very labor intensive. But it doesn't have to be. I think there are so many digital solutions available today. When you think of mobile apps that can send push notifications to keep employees informed of new offerings that are being made available to them, I would say a key point for the viewers is to remember that you don't have to go this alone. There are plenty of licensed agents and brokers who can partner with your company and help you explore ways where you can really maximize the benefit offerings that you're making available to your employees.
So how has business preparedness evolved to address the future health and safety needs as we move forward?
I think owners seem to understand with a greater degree of clarity today the need to focus on what it means to keep people safe and productive at work. You know, a key outcome of everything we've been talking about is with changes in your business environment come potential changes with risk. Take cyber, for example. So you had a lot of small business owners who may have had a brick and mortar retail establishment who had to close their doors, and to stay afloat, they had to shift to now a digital e-commerce solution. Well, with that change in business operations comes now changes to risk, where you have cyber threats and cyber attacks that you have to, you know, be worried about that you may not have had to consider in the past. I think another great example are all the restaurants that we would all frequent, right? And where you had these amazing dine-in experiences. Well, through the pandemic, these restaurants, many of them successfully figured out how to close their dining rooms, but transitioned over to now a delivery model to stay afloat. And so with that change in business operations, you now have a wait staff that's delivering food. Well, if you have a workers' compensation policy, there's implications to that policy, right? And I think here's where there's value in learning to, you know, protect your employees. It's gonna help you protect your business, involve licensed agents and brokers that can take a new fresh look and a fresh set of eyes on your business operations to make sure that you're mitigating risk as best you can in this new day and age that we're working in.
Such great insight. Jim Lord, SVP and GM, ADP Insurance Services. We really appreciate your time, Jim. Thank you.